I want to say very clearly that the judiciary is the one holding both the executive and the legislature. And if there's any problem during the after election, you run to judiciary. If there's any problem during administration, you run to the judiciary. And our own take is that judiciary must be properly put in its best position. And that is the reason why we are supporting Juson.
And we've come here to press on the point that this ought to be observed, you know, because the Constitution is sacrosanct and is a document that underpins the very essence of our existence. Therefore, all responsible government at all levels should ensure full compliance with the constitutional provisions. Government should not pick and choose what provision of the Constitution to comply with. So we were Mr. Governor today. The listening governor, he met us at a very short notice, less than 24 hours, because of the sort of regard he has for the bar. So he met with us, and both sides, we had a dialogue, and we heard from the other side of the coin. Of course, before we came here, we knew Lagos State had, you know, partly or partially complied with this constitutional provision, and it confirmed the fact that in terms of recurrent expenditure, Lagos State has complied 100%, and in terms of capital expenditure, it's complied 75%. And in Lagos State, no judiciary goes cap in hand to the executive to beg for funds. They all go to the House of Assembly to justify their budget. But all that said, whether there is full compliance or not in Lagos, we've pressed on the point that this is something that ought to be done.